Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. We're just wrapping up our second day of installing a radon system on this house. This house is in the West Metro of Minneapolis, Minnesota. It was built in 1948 and had an initial radon level of 13.4. And it's got a few oddities or things that make it unique, and we thought it'd be a good opportunity to do a video on it, and hopefully it helps you. So the couple of factors, the X factors we had here was this well room right under this plant here. The customer actually didn't know they had it, but I noticed the plywood there when I was bidding the job, and like, we don't know what's back there. So we pulled it off, and it was a well room with a dirt floor, and we knew it was going to be a factor. Also, I would love to have a suction point in that well room, but it's a living room above it, no closet, so we can't run a pipe out of it. And the customer did not want a fan on the outside of the house, just as much as I didn't want a fan on the outside of the house. So we want to maintain the aesthetics. The other thing is this little front entry area. We did set up our eco trackers when I was bidding the house or bidding the job, and this didn't really seem to be a factor, but that well room was really hot when I was bidding the job. I took the cover off and it was reading at like 26. And climbing. So let's go ahead and take a look inside and see how we came out. So we've got a detached garage, so obviously we couldn't go to the garage like we like to do, which left us with only the option to go up through a closet to get into the attic. So back here is like the mechanical room area. We could have done an outside system, but you know, those are ugly and the customer didn't want that. And you can see our pipe up on the roof is where we exit, that brown pipe. So let's head in the house now. So we'll just kind of start with an overview down here. So we've got a bedroom here to my left. We've got the furnace in this little mechanical room here. The well room is right up here. So once you get a shot of that, so they have it for reference. Well room is behind that plywood there. And then coming this way, so we've got the stairway there, which is kind of the living room area. We've got a bathroom here, so the toilet is over there, the shower is here. And then coming in this area, kind of our unfinished area, or our second unfinished area. And we've got plumbing here, we've got the toilet that backs up right there. We've got where the water comes in from the sewer right here. When I bid the job, I knew that well room would probably be a factor, especially since it was so hot. So I didn't want to start with the well room just because there wasn't an easy path to get over to it. So we'll take a look and see kind of how I bid the job. So in that well room, I could look up, the block openings were all open to the rim joist or the rim joist area. So I knew the house was pulling radon from that well room and then kind of was distributing throughout here. And then that front step area is there. So I thought initially maybe one or two suction points to treat the basement slab. And then that didn't really look, that front step area didn't really look like that was going to be a factor. Just because our radon monitors in there weren't like a lot higher than the rest of the house. But that well room, obviously I knew that could be a factor. Now, unfortunately, there's no easy way to get pipe over there. So we talked about stitching from this corner because this is the unfinished area. We actually ended up with a suction point right on the other side of the wall here. So we could have pulled the carpet up, stitched over, so we'd have a tunnel over into here, and then we could transition to pipe and go into that well room to treat that. We also could have went over, you know, demoed parts of the ceiling to get pipe in here, or possibly extended the soffit out. But then they're, you know, working with texturing the ceiling and drywall and paint and framing that in and kind of the mess that comes along with that. So the customer opted for the stitching option should we need it. But we wanted to do it in phase. So phase one was seal that well room. Let's take a look at that. Not a lot of room here. Took this cover off and then all these block tops were open. So I foamed all the block tops, the sides of the block, the bottom, to stop that opening, the connection that we had right here, because all these block tops are open, so it could just pull air up and into the house. So I foamed all that, and then I put a radon monitor in there. I had a radon eye in there, and then I screwed the cover back down, and then I ended up duct taping this so because I knew I'd have to get back in there, so I didn't want to seal it permanently because I wanted to get my monitor out. And we were able to watch those radon levels. They climbed and climbed and climbed. It was like 76, I think, last time I looked at it. And then it spiked at 100 and maxed out the eco tracker. So the other part of phase one was to get the system up and running. So we got this sealed, and then we'll head over to the other room and see what we did there. So we want to get that system up and running so we can see what the radon levels were this morning and see if we needed to treat that well room. So we started by putting in our test holes. So we had three test holes. We ended up with a first suction point over here because we're next to plumbing. You know, there's a lot of settling here. We've got the main drain right back here, and then we've got a lot of plumbing that runs through here. So we want to be next to plumbing to take advantage of that disturbed soil, the settling, so we can easily pull air through that. So we did put the suction point here, ran our numbers, and we had just very slight PFE over by that well room. So we were reaching it, but we were just kind of tickling it. Would have been a high suction fan, would have been noisy, a little bit more expensive to operate, and the customer here is very sensitive to noise. So we looked at how can we make it better. We can do that with another suction point. So we ended up with one right in the corner here, which is essentially located in the house, closer to that well room, and allowed us to reach everything with pulling a lot less air. We ended up putting in all the pipe to tie everything together, and then it goes up through a closet, through a bedroom closet, and then into the attic, and then out through the roof. We ended up with a Fantech RN1, which would be one of the smallest radon fans. The equivalent would be a Radonaway RP140 or the Festus Spirit. So we ended up with a very quiet, pretty energy efficient system versus going with one suction point and trying to overpower all the air leaks that we might encounter along the way and just kind of try to tickle that side. So we might have had marginal results. The fan is pulling 17 watts. We're at 38 CFM currently, but we still got to seal all the cracks in the floor. And there's quite a bit of cracks we can seal here. So that is going to change a little bit better. Pressure field will get stronger. So what we ended up with for pressure field extension, this is with both our valves open and no sealing yet. We've got 12 pascals negative in this test hole. And then the one right in front of the door to the well room, we've got 4 pascals negative. So we're reaching everything, and that's what we were at last night. But coming back this morning, I was really happy to see all our radon eyes were down, or our radon monitors, our eco trackers, were down to 0.5 picocuries. The one that we had sealed in the well room was at 15, and it was continuing to fall. So it had not leveled out. And the customer was really happy. We didn't have to do the stitching. So we were able to use not only diagnostics by measuring pressure field extension, but the radon monitors to determine that, hey, we didn't have to spend a whole bunch of money and time to stitch over there and capture that well room because this system is working to reduce the radon levels everywhere. So if you found the video helpful, please consider liking and subscribing. It does help with YouTube algorithm to share it with more people, and that helps save more lives. If you are interested in purchasing the eco trackers, we've got a promo code. We'll put that down in the description, as well as some of the other products that we use. If you're interested in looking at those, check out the description below. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.